as they are distracting performers and other members of tonight's audience. Thank you for familiarizing yourself with the concert etiquette information located on the back cover of your program. Enjoy the performance.
Hey everyone, my name is Olivia and I'm a junior at CA. Welcome to our awesome multicultural orchestra concert. We are super excited to have you here tonight. This is where we get to blend the coolest music from all around the world and share it with you. Our orchestra is like a group of musical explorers, and each song we play is like a different adventure. So, as we dive into each song, we want you to feel the vibes and stories behind the music. Let it take you on a journey to a far-off place. No more waiting. Let's get the music going. Get ready to groove because our multicultural orchestra concert is about to take you on an epic musical ride. Thanks for being a part of it. And now to kick off the concert, Symphony Orchestra and Caitlin Newhook to introduce the first piece.
Hey everyone, my name is Caitlin and I'm a sophomore here at Canandaigua Academy. Our first musical adventure tonight takes us all the way to India, a land of vibrant traditions and rich history. The piece we're about to perform is called Jahind, which means Hail India or Long Live India. It's like a musical love letter celebrating spirit and resilience. But that is not all. In this arrangement, the second piece is called Jana Gana Mana, which happens to be the national anthem of India. It originally came to life as a part of a poem written way back in 1870. This poem turned into a song and was later adopted as India's national song. It's a symbol of unity and pride that resonates with millions of people. To add a touch of Bollywood magic, the final song in this arrangement is a burst of energy and color. Bollywood is all about catching melodies, intricate dances, and storytelling through music. It combines the best of Indian films and music culture. So get ready to be transported to the heart of India as we play Jahand. Let the sound of this incredible country fill your hearts and spirits. Without further ado, let's bring a piece of India to our stage.
Thank you. Thank you. everyone. My name is Kim, and I am a sophomore. As we continue our musical journey, we arrive at a deeply emotional piece, a traditional Jewish folk song called Ani Ma'ami, which translates to I Believe in Hebrew. This song holds within it a profound history and a message of hope that has touched the hearts of generations. Ani Ma'ami is more than just a melody. It's a testament to the resilience of the human spirit. During one of the darkest periods in history, this song provided comfort to the victims and survivors of the Holocaust. It served as a beacon of hope, a reminder that even in the face of the unimaginable hardship, the belief in a better future and the inherent goodness of humanity can endure. In this moment, we honor the memory of those who persevered through unimaginable challenges and the enduring strength of the Jewish people. We also celebrate the universal message of Ani Ma'ami, which reminds us all to hold on to hope, to believe in a brighter tomorrow, and to stand together. The beauty of music lies in its ability to convey profound emotions and stories, and tonight, Ani Ma'ami serves as a testament to that power. As we perform this traditional Hebrew song, let its hauntingly beautiful melody and timeless message resonate in your hearts.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. My name is Haley Moore, and I'm the orchestra director here at Canandaigua Academy, and I'm so pleased that you're all here to join us this evening. This has been one of the most enjoyable concerts to plan and rehearse because there's such a diversity in the music that we're playing tonight. And these students have worked really, really hard, and they've been dedicated to their music, practicing in school during free periods and after school, and working with me on solos and things like that, and I feel incredibly grateful to be able to work with such amazing students. So give them a round of applause for me. Symphony Orchestra has one more piece for you tonight, and then we have two more groups playing, so stick around. Make sure you encourage your students to support their peers. It's always a great thing to do here at Canandaigua, and enjoy the rest of the concert.
Hola a todos. My name is Marley Kuzma, and I'm a ninth grader here at Canandaigua Academy. We bring you a piece that's as colorful and vibrant as the celebration it portrays. Our last performance is entitled Dia de los Muertos, which means Day of the Dead. This festival depicts the joyous celebration that takes place in Mexico and various Latin American countries in the beginning of November. On Dia de los Muertos, according to a popular belief, the spirits of the deceased return to commune with the living. It's a time to honor and remember our loved ones who have passed away, celebrating their lives so they may rest in peace. The atmosphere is filled with music, colorful altars, and an abundance of marigold flowers known as the Cempasúchil to guide the spirits back to the world of the living. But there's a fascinating twist to this piece. It begins with a quote from Dies Irae, which translates to Day of Wrath. Now, Dies Irae has a rich history in classical and popular music. Originally, it was part of Latin hymn in a Catholic liturgy, reflecting themes of judgment and end of the world. Over time, it has been used in various compositions and movies to convey a sense of doom and foreboding. The last part of this piece, known as the Dance of the Little Old Men, is derived from the Dies Irae. In some regions of Mexico, boys perform the dance initially hobbling around with canes, symbolizing the pain of old age, and wearing masks to resemble elderly individuals. As the dance progresses, it transforms into a joyous celebration, with the dancers becoming young and stomping around merrily. It's a symbolic representation of the cycle of life and the belief that death is not the end, but a continuation of existence in a different form. So as we perform Dia de los Muertos, listen for the echoes of Dies Irae and witness the transformation from somber reflection to an exuberant celebration. Enjoy!
Thank you. Howdy, folks. I'm Ezra, and I'm a senior. We're kicking off our fiddle club portion of the concert with a journey into the heart of the Appalachian Mountains, where the echoes of generations past still ring in the tunes of the fiddle. The first piece we're about to play is a lively medley called Dusty River, combining two traditional Appalachian tunes, Dry and Dusty and Duck River. Dry and Dusty is an old-time melody found its roots in the Ozark Mountains. It's a tune with rich history, dating back to the early days of recorded music. Fiddlers in Missouri, Texas, and Arkansas left their mark on this piece, preserving the musical traditions of the region. When you listen to Dry and Dusty, you can almost feel the dusty trails and rugged landscapes of the Ozarks. The second tune, Duck River, takes us deeper into the Appalachian tradition. What makes these Appalachian fiddle tunes special is their distinctive AABB format, which gives them their characteristic repetitive and danceable quality. They're like musical conversations, with the fiddler and the audience engaging in a joyful back and forth. So as we perform Dusty River, let the soulful melodies of the Appalachian Mountains transport you to a simpler time, where the fiddle was the heart and soul of the community. Get ready for a foot tapping, hand clapping good time as we play for you Dusty River.
Hello, everyone. I'm Emma, and I'm a freshman here at CA. We're wrapping up our Fiddle Club concert tonight with a tune that will transport you across the Atlantic to the rolling hills of Ireland. Our final piece is a traditional Irish reel, a lively and spirited melody known as Red Haired Boy. But this tune isn't just an Irish gem. It has also found its way into the heart of American old-time and bluegrass music, becoming a beloved standard. What makes this tune even more fascinating is the intricate fiddle technique employed, known as the chop. It's a rhythmic and percussive technique that adds a unique dimension to the music. If you watch closely, you see our string players hitting their flat bow hairs on the string very closely to the bridge, creating a crisp and rhythmic sound that's both captivating and energizing. As you listen to Red Haired Boy, let the reels and rhythms carry you away to the Emerald Isle, where the fiddle's voice tells stories of tradition, folklore, and the joy of dancing. This tune has a way of making you want to tap your feet and join in celebration, no matter where you come from. So get ready for a performance of Red Haired Boy. Let the fiddle and the chop take you on a musical journey that spans continents and transcends time. It's a perfect way to conclude our concert tonight, celebrating the fusion of cultures and the universal language of music. Enjoy.
Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Sylvia and I am a sophomore. Tonight we will begin our chamber orchestra concert with a vibrant and exuberant piece titled Jambo. But what's Jambo, you might wonder? Well, it's a Swahili greeting, and it carries the same warm and welcoming spirit as hello, with an exclamation mark. The composer of this piece, Paul Bassler, had a remarkable journey that inspired his music. He lived in Nairobi from 1993 to 1994, serving as the senior Fulbright lecturer of music at Kenyatta University. During his time there, he immersed himself in the culture and musical traditions of Kenya, which left an impression on his compositional style. Jambo reflects the infectious joy and boundless optimism of the Kenyan people. It's a musical celebration of the vibrant spirit that defines this beautiful country. In Kenya, there's a beloved song called Jambo Bwana, which has been sung by many different bands and music groups, becoming a symbol of unity and goodwill. Traditionally, the heartbeat of African music is the percussion. And in this piece, we pay homage to that tradition. Instead of the traditional African drum called the djembe, our rhythmic foundation is provided by the viola section, acting as our djembe section. They create a powerful rhythmic undertow that carries us through the energetic landscape of Jambo. So as we embark on this musical journey tonight, let Jambo be our warm and spirited greeting to you. Feel the pulse of Kenya in our music and let it fill your hearts with joy and optimism. Without further ado, let the enchanting sounds of Jambo transport you to the heart of Kenya, where the music is as vibrant and welcoming as the people themselves. Enjoy the journey.
Thank you. Hola a todos, I'm Zach. Our musical journey continues with Fantasia Española, a piece that takes us on a vibrant and colorful tour of Spanish traditions. From the dramatic costumes and intricate rhythms to the world of bullfights and captivating dances, this composition is a celebration of all things Spanish. Picture the lively festivals of Spain, where every corner is alive with the spirit of fiesta. The music you're about to hear is inspired by these rich traditions, and it's a window into the heart and soul of a passionate culture. But what makes Fantasia Española even more intriguing is the way it incorporates unique string techniques to bring the Spanish essence to life. One of these techniques is coleño, where the musicians play on the wooden stick of the bow to create a percussive effect. It's like the rhythmic beat of castanets or the stamping of feet in a flamenco dance, adding a layer of authenticity to the music. Additionally, we use a strumming technique to stimulate the soulful and sultry sound of Spanish guitars. It's as if we've transported the essence of a Spanish Plaza de Toros, or a bustling street filled with passionate guitarists, right onto our stage. So, as you listen to Fantasia Española, let your imagination carry you to the heart of Spain, where the spirit of fiesta is alive in every note. Feel the pulse of the Spanish traditions and the passionate rhythms that drive the music. Tonight, our orchestra becomes a canvas, painting the vivid colors of Spain with our strings and bows. Fantasia Española invites you to experience the magic of Spain through music, and we hope you'll be swept away by its allure. Without further ado, let's embark on this magical journey to Spain, where every note is a step in a passionate dance, and every melody is an echo of centuries-old traditions. Enjoy the fiesta.
In advance, sorry if I butcher any of this. Ni hao, everyone. My name is Percy, and I'm a sophomore. Tonight, our musical journey takes us to the captivating and diverse region of Yunnan, located in the southwestern part of China. Yunnan is often referred to as the South of Clouds, is a place of breathtaking beauty, characterized by majestic mountains, winding rivers, and abundant natural treasures. From the heart of Yunnan comes a traditional folk song called A Little Stream, lovingly arranged by Albert Wang. This beautiful melody encapsulates the essence of Yunnan, a province known for its rich cultural tapestry and vibrant ethnic diversity. Within its vast territory, numerous ethnic minorities coexist, contributing to the unique charm of the region. Yunnan's borders stretch into the west, where it meets Burma, and to the south, where it shares boundary with Vietnam and Laos. This geographical diversity has enriched the cultural heritage of Yunnan, and A Little Stream is a testament to the enduring spirit of this remarkable place. The enchanting melody of A Little Stream has transcended gender I'm really struggling tonight. Has transcended generations, becoming a cherished tune passed through the city, through the Chinese culture. Its enduring popularity is a testament to the power of music to capture the heart and soul of a place and its people. As you listen to this piece tonight, let the music carry you into the tranquil landscapes of Yunnan, where the melodies flow like rivers that wind through its terrain. Now, without further delay, let us embark on this musical journey to Yunnan, where A Little Stream becomes a river of melodies, connecting us to the rich heritage and the natural wonders of this remarkable province. Enjoy the beauty and serenity of the South Clouds.
Good evening. My name is Taryn. Our musical journey tonight concludes with a powerful and evocative piece, Baltic Dance. This composition transports us to a pivotal moment in history, one that resonates deeply with the Baltic states' struggle for independence from the Soviet Union in 1991. The citizens of the Baltic states celebrated their newfound independence with a dance, a joyful declaration of freedom that reverberated through the region. Baltic Dance captures the spirit of this momentous occasion, paying homage to the tenacity and resilience of the people who fought for their right to self-determination. One of the standout features of this piece is its use of multimeters, a characteristic commonly found in the music of the Baltic region. The contrast between duple and triple meters reflects the intricate and richly layered musical traditions of the Baltics. These rhythmic elements create a sense of tension, mirroring the complex history and struggles faced by the Baltic states. As we reach the culmination of Baltic Dance, you'll notice a dramatic shift in the music. The dance rhythms give way to a straight Russian rhythm, serving as a powerful metaphor for the tenacity and resilience of the Baltic independence movement. It's a poignant reminder of the challenges faced and the determination required to secure freedom. Tonight, as you listen to Baltic Dance, let the music transport you to the Baltic region where the rhythms of history and culture intertwine. May the music inspire us all to embrace the values of freedom and unity.